Hello and welcome to our Feature Friday. My name is Ronnie Blass. I'm working at Bystronic as application specialist. Today we will explain a little bit the MTC, the modular tool changer. First of all, of course, you know all the bending machines. Normally you fit the tools manually in the machine. This means I place the bottom tool and the top tool manual on the right position, and then I can start to bending. Today we like to show how we do it with the tool changer, and first of all is how we get all the tools inside the tool changer. This is really simple. First we go to our software for the tool changer. You see the overview from our stock. We have the left stock, the middle stock, and the right one. And the first what we like to do is loading new tools. We have to select the right tools, of course. The top tools is in P5 and the bottom tool is an V6S tool, and then we press the start button. After this, the robot will move in front of the machine. You will see it now. And we have a little laser beam inside. You see this red area, and we scan the whole area of the top tool and also the whole area of the bottom tool to select or detect the different tool segments we have put in the machine. Of course, you can put in the whole machine full of the machine with the tools. We need just a small distance between the segments, and you can use like the area from here to around about here. You see these little points. This is the area we can scan the tools. If you are finishing for the top tool, you will see the robot move automatically to the bottom tool and do the scanning again. All the segments the robot detect over the laser beam, we get in a small list. This is just to double check that everything is okay and the robot have detected the right tool segments. And if we are finished with this, you see, now we are more or less in the middle of the bottom tool area. Then we can say, okay, the top tool and the bottom tool are the right one and can adopt this, and the robot move the tool to the stock. I don't need to program on what for place I will have the segments. The robot defined the best place for these segments. This means that I have the full stock used with all the tools and that I don't miss some space. So, okay, now the robot is finished. We hit the OK button. We can double check. I have said before, just press the adapt button, and if I close this window, then you see a little bit more on the screen from our stock. The robot take the tool and place it to the stock. How I said, you don't need to program on what for place you will have it, and how to move the robot to this position. This goes fully automatically. Then the bottom tool, and after finishing this process, the robot goes back to the home position and we can do the next thing on the robot. Okay, this is really, really simple to do it and to learn new tools in the machine. Everyone can do it by itself. Okay, how it works if we load and program and take out tools from our stock? This is really easy. We load, of course, a new program. I take this one, say open, and then we go back to the robot program, and here we see the situation in green, how the robot will move the tools inside the machine. I can decide I will change the top tools and also the bottom tool, press the start button. I get the message, just in case, if I put some tools manually inside, that I have to remove it, of course, otherwise I get the problem with the robot. I say, in my case, okay, and the robot start to take out all the tools I have programmed to the clamping. Okay, and this time I can a little bit explain technical things from the robot. First of all, we can put in the modular tool changer on every Expert Pro machines, if it's an extended version and if the machine have 6-axis baggage. You can use it on a 3-meter machine, and you can also use it on a 4-meter machine. For the tools segments and also the tool shape we can use, you see we have different tools we can use. The standard top tool is for the tool changer in the height 250 mm. You can also use tools like this one. This is 350 mm. And we can also have different shapes. You see this little goose neck tool. We have a complete straight tool, and we can also have a bigger goose neck tool like this. A really big advantage of our system is that you don't need to hold two stocks for tools. You can rotate. We can rotate internally our tools like this segment. We have a little station inside. The robot can rotate this and then place the tool on the right position, also in the rotated version. For the segmentation, we can handle tool segmentation from 30 to 550 mm. These are the top tool. Maybe I also change the bottom tool, of course, that we have also different bottom tools. A little bit depend how big is the tool. We decide the maximum length over the weight of the tool. This means we can maximum handle tools with 25 kilograms. In this case, we decide that maybe the segment could be a little bit smaller. For the bottom tools, we can handle all the tools we have in our catalog, the standard tools from V6, is like a tool like this. We can also handle this tool, this is 55 mm in the high, or you can use tools with the high of 100 mm. And if you ask what is the biggest one, this is also a really advantage, we can also move tools like this. This is a V120 mm. Of course, you can here not handle 500 mm long tools, but we can also handle 200 and 300 mm segments that you can really fast change the tools. You have seen this goes really, really fast for the top tools and the bottom tools. The last segment, let me explain, is 550 mm, and in the high 500 is more or less the longest segment you can also handle for the bottom tool. Okay, so far all the stuff over the MTC. Now I go back to the colleague. He can answer all your questions. Thank you and goodbye.
So, welcome from my side. My name is Carsten Trautvetter. I'm the product manager for Bending, based here in Gotha in the Competence Center for Bending in Germany. I'm happy that you have been joining us, and I think we all are happy that you have been joining us, and I hope it was interesting. So far, tool changer, we have this in the market now since about 5 years. The tool changer you have just seen downstairs is now the second generation. And it's a really flexible system. When we want to understand how tool changers are working and what is the point of a tool changer in our business, is when you just have to look in the market of machining centers. Some of you maybe are using machining centers, like milling centers from some companies, and when you buy these machines today, there is not even one machine which has no automatic tool change anymore. This was about 20 years before completely different, and this has changed dramatically. We think it's the same in our market with tool changing. At the moment, about 99% of our customers worldwide are still changing the tools manually, and we have been trying to giving them a good solution on the hand to do all of this in the future completely automatically. You have seen from Ronnie that this is completely flexible, it's easy to use, you don't need so much additional training for this new solution. It's the same user interface as a standard bending machine, so it's not so much more you need to know. You don't need to know anything about the robot. The robot is just the unit which is handling the tool. And you don't need to worry about this robot in this tool changer at all. It's a really flexible solution. You have seen this for 3-meter machines. We have a space of about 40 meters of tools. For a 4-meter machine, we have about 50 meters of tools space available in this tool changer. So it's really flexible. It's made for also thick applications as well. Now you can handle lower tools with a V opening of about V120 with this tool changer. So material thickness of 10 millimeter material thickness and even above this is no problem to handle with this machine and bend with this machine and change the tools for this machines. And this is also in our opinion really important because especially also there it becomes also more important to move tools in and out easily and very efficient because this kind of tools are really, really heavy. Then one more point is what you have seen, this tool changer can handle tool segments of about 515 millimeters. This is about half a meter and this means you are really fast in the tool setup. And that's one big additional plus point of our tool changing solution, that we can handle this huge segments and can put them in a really fast time. So with this, I see we have no questions so far. And I would like to start this with the questions. And we have prepared a number of questions in Slido here. And we have here this Slido code, this event code. Please follow us with this. What you do is you just take your mobile phone and you have usually a Dynamatrix code reader on this and you can scan this Dynamatrix code with the mobile phone and as soon as you have been scanning this, you enter Slido. Now Slido, this is a free application and you don't need to install anything on your mobile phone. You can also go to slido.com. You don't need to add your name or anything. You just go to slido.com and you enter this event code, what you see here. That's hashtag BY0406. That's the event code for this event. And I hope some of you will follow us into Slido to make this a little bit more interactive, this event. So the first question we have here is what percentage of your working time do you spend with tool changing? So it's a question. So what percentage of the time during your day, how much time do you spend on tool changing? No? I don't speak about the material handling now. When you bend, actually, you just change the tool, you set up your machine. That's the question. What is your feeling? How much time do you spend with tool changing? Is it about 50%, 30%? 40%, is it even above 50%? So we have already now 8 voters and it's a right variety of voters in here. I just want to mention, we have done last week our Digital Technology Days bending automation and there we have been presenting different solutions for an efficient tool change process. There have been not just a tool changer, no, what we have just seen. There are also software solutions available. Like our tool setup optimizer. This was presented, for example, from Benjamin Bansamer and from Ronnie Blass in the software part of the presentation. And there you can still see this on YouTube. Just type in on YouTube technology day bending and bending automation from Bistronic. And you can find this also via Facebook or Instagram. And there we have been presenting also different solutions, not just with the tool changer, also software solutions. How you can take your process or make it more efficient. What we have been presenting there was a typical customer case also in this technology day. Typical customers, this was for example about 15 job changes per day, 15 job changes, and this customer, for example, with just 15 job changes, one day, but when I say one day, I mean one shift. No? So it's about 15 job changes. We have been analyzing that this operator was moving about half a ton, so 500 kilogram und tools, this operator will move in the worst case. Ne? Let's say you have an experienced operator, of course he will set up the machine in this way that he don't have to move so many tools in and out. But an operator who has maybe less experience, he will try to bend this 15 jobs, he don't know. Maybe what's the most efficient tool set up, and then in the worst case he can handle about 500 kilogram just of tools. It's not a material handling. Yeah? He has to handle his material as well, his sheet metal, his bent parts, but it's just the tools, half a ton, and that's something what is typical at many of our customer places. So we have now 10 voters. So most of you spend about 40% in tool changing. Yeah, that's interesting. 40% of your time is waste time at the end, because you don't need this. Adds no additional value to your product. Ne? When your customer is asking you, why is this bent part now so expensive? You say, nah, because the tool changing process is 40% of my daytime, and the customer tells you, so what? What does it mean? And this is a big issue, and for this reason, we have the tool changer. You have seen this downstairs, how efficient this tool changer is working. And when you are wondering now, yeah, what is the operator doing during this time? Yeah, he is doing now, he prepares the next job. Ne? He brings the new parts in, brings the other parts away. No, and he's doing everything what he would do anyway. No? After a tool changing process, he would spend time anyway for a coffee or for something else to make a break. And maybe he needs even more breaks because of he was lifting 500 kilograms of tools in his shift. And so this tool changer can reduce this 40%, or some customers have even above 50%. That's the reason why we have this here. This is the reason why this tool changing process is the process where you can save most time, and you can reduce the cost, and at the end you can reduce the price how you produce your parts, and you can give them at a lower price, a lower cost, lower to your customer. So we have one more question. If you still want to join us in Slido and you lost connection, it's easy. You have here still the data matrix code. Just scan the data matrix code, and with the data matrix code, you join us in our Slido event. The other way is also you just go into slido.com and you enter this code, this hashtag. It's hashtag BY0406. And the next question is here, what do you think, how heavy is a 515 millimeter segment, what we have seen in the presentation? Is it 5 kilogram, is it 9 kilogram, is it 13 kilogram, is it 20, is it 26 kilogram? So we have already a number of voters here, and I give you a little bit more time to answer this question. I have here one thing with me. It's my equipment from home. I use at home. It's a present from my wife, special for me, for cleaning the floor. And it has 10 liters. 10 liters capacity here in this. And it's for cleaning the floor in our house. As I said, it was a present from my wife for me. And it's 10 liters. And this has something to do with our question, to give you the feeling how heavy a tooling segment is, just half a meter. And this is something what your operator has to handle several times. This means when you look at this operator, what we just said with half a ton, he is moving 50 of this, 50 of this every shift. And there are even sometimes operators who have to handle up to 1 ton. No? Then you have 100 of this moved, and you have not bent even one part. No? You don't even bend one part during your shift. You just spend your time in moving this. So this has something to do with it. Now we have 10 voters. Let's see what we have. And about exactly 13 kilogram is the right answer. It's the weight of this segment. It's 13 kilogram. So, and this here, this has just 10 kilogram. Yeah? And it's just 10 kilogram, it's enough for me. And 10 liters, around about 10 kilogram. And there you see what the operators have to do every day. So 13 kilogram is really massive when you move this all day long. So thank you for this voting. We have one more question for you. And the last question is, How many meters of bending tools do you have in your fabrication on each machine? What is this on your machine? What do you have on your machine? Is it more than 50 meters? Is it 10 meters, 20 meters, 30 meters, 40 meters? What is how much tooling do you have on your machine typically? So it's also, we have been looking in the market before when we launched the tool changer. Our first generation of the tool changer has a capacity of 30 meters of upper and lower tooling. This was the first generation. Now we have just seen this was the second generation. The second generation we launched last year of this modular tool changer, which you can retrofit to every Export Pro which is in the market. So you just put it on like a trailer. It's easy to retrofit this solution. And now, as I told you, this new solution has now in 3 meter about 40 millimeters capacity for tools, and on 4 meter it has 50 meters capacity of tools. You can have in really high upper tools, for example. Our customers need a lot of flexibility. They asked us to have upper tools in which are 350 millimeters or even bigger. So for big box bending, this capacity we can handle with this tool changer completely automatically. And as I said, especially these tools are really heavy. And you need a lot of power to move just the tools. And you haven't bent one part. You didn't earn any money with this tool changing process. And that's the point where you can save a lot of money. And you see here, now many of you have even above 50 meters of tools in the factory. And as I said, in the 4 meter version, that's no problem to do this, to have this 50 meters of tools on board of the machine. And when you look at the majority of the people, they have between 10 and 50 meters of tooling. And for this people, I think they are maybe typical users also of a 3 meter machine. There it's probably enough to have 40 meters of tooling. So this was our Slido questions. Thank you for joining us in Slido. It's helping us also to go in the right direction with further developments. I can just ask you to join us on our landing page. So if you would like to see an individual demonstration of the tool changer just for you with your parts, we do this now in a daily work online, like this event here, live with customers. Customers send us the parts, the drawings. We organize the material, for example, and we demonstrate then how we bend these parts on, for example, the tool changer, job by job. And there you can see how much time you can save with the tool changing process and how much faster you get and how we can handle your parts in the most efficient way. We have customers, they send us 1 week of production, for example, and they will ask us, oh, please optimize my production process. We have done also this. We have good software tools for this. It's called AutoPart. You can see about AutoPart even more in our Technology Days bending. As I told you last week, they have been live. You can still watch this Technology Days bending in German and in English. They are still on YouTube. Just enter YouTube and search for Technology Days bending automation, and there you will find all this content. And there you see, for example, AutoPart, this feature where we load a number of parts in, and then we search for the right bending sequence, and then we search for the right setup process, and we can optimize your setup process for one shift, three shifts, and maybe 1 week or even 1 month. It's not a problem. It's more interesting for you, because if you want to invest in new equipment, it's interesting for you when you get your money back. So I can just invite you, use our landing page. It's easy to use. You just go on our homepage and enter this, join this landing page. You have to do three steps there. You choose the date and you choose the machines you would like to see. All our equipment of the Experience Center here in Gotha in Germany, you will see there. And then you just send this request to us. So it's two active steps and one you have to press the send button, and then we have your date, and we will confirm as soon as possible, and then you can do your live demonstration online, but you can go also on site. Germany, as many places worldwide, opening again. So the Corona virus or crisis is going backwards a little bit, at least for the summertime, it seems. And we really invite you. We have seen yesterday the first customers from Poland, for example, here in our demo center. And we are really happy to have all of you again here in our experience and demo center. So I see we have no more questions so far about our tool changer. So then I come to the last point. I just want to mention our last feature Friday. It's the last feature Friday for this spring, for the beginning of the year. So we're going now into summer break after this last feature Friday. The last feature Friday will be at the end of June, 25th of June. It will take place. It will have the topic sheet metal handling, for example, with dynamic sheet supports. And we just would like to invite you again here for this, because also the sheet support, for example, you can save in second operator, which gives you a lot of savings. Now, we spent a lot of time in the last couple of weeks also with the technology day, spending automation to show you all our automation solutions, how you can handle all the parts completely automatically. About 95% of the customers worldwide still handle every part manually with an operator. So we have also there still really good equipment available, and we develop more and more for this, because this will not change from one year to the other, that everybody is moving completely in automation. This will go, in our opinion, step by step. So we invite you for our next event, for our next live feature Friday. This will take place on Friday, the 25th of June. So with this, we are at the end of our live event for today. I hope it was a little bit interesting for you. And if we didn't cover all aspects of your interest, just don't hesitate to contact us. No, you can contact us also, as I said, via the landing page. We make an individual demo for you. You can go over Facebook, Instagram, and for example also LinkedIn, and get in contact with us and ask for more information about our features. So with this, I'm at the end, and I hope you have a good weekend. Stay healthy, and hope to see you soon here live in our experience center in Germany, or in one of our experience centers worldwide, or at the exhibitions worldwide, which are taking place, as far as I know, from now again. Many countries are opening. All the best. See you soon. Bye-bye.